As a leader in the design and manufacturing of aircraft alternators, we frequently see instances where the improper installation of the gear drive coupling has caused severe damage or catastrophic alternator and engine failure. The following video demonstrates the correct way to install the gear drive coupling on a permold Continental engine to ensure optimum alternator performance and longevity. The following tools are required to complete the gear coupling installation: 15/16 inch box end wrench, gear coupling spanner wrench, 5/16 inch hex drive socket, coupling torque tool, 0 to 750 inch pound or 0 to 62.5 foot pound torque wrench, diagonal cutter, and aviation grade oil. All of the following parts should be replaced with new in accordance with the current version of the Continental Motors Maintenance Manual M-0, standard practice for spark-ignited engines. We do not recommend reusing any of these parts. New copper-faced thrust washer. New rotor shaft woodruff key. New slotted retaining nut. New cotter pin. You will need the following installation documentation to complete the installation: the most current revision of Continental Motors Maintenance Manual M-0, standard practice for spark-ignited engines, and HET Service Information Letter A-140, Revision 1. Using the spanner wrench and coupling torque tool, perform the 646-655 drive coupling slippage procedure in accordance with Continental Motors Maintenance Manual M-0, standard practice for spark-ignited engines, and Table 10.4, alternator drive hub slippage. If the coupling is not serviceable, it must be replaced. Whether the unit is new or overhauled, the steps for properly installing the gear drive coupling are the same and must be followed precisely to ensure proper installation. Inspect the unit and remove any shipping hardware from the alternator. Prior to 2014, Hartzell Engine Technologies alternators were shipped with a metal shipping washer installed. These washers are not part of the installation and must be removed. If you are reinstalling an in-service alternator, then replace the woodruff key before installation in accordance with Continental Motors Maintenance Manual M-0, standard practice for spark-ignited engines. Whether new or replaced, inspect that the woodruff key is properly seated. Verify that there is a lubricated O-ring installed on the rotor shaft spacer. With the O-ring in position, install the inspected or new drive coupling so that it is flush against the rotor shaft spacer. Install the new copper-faced thrust washer with the copper side facing the alternator body. Before installing the retaining nut, lubricate the shaft and threading with aviation-grade oil. While holding the installed retaining nut with a 15/16 inch box end wrench, torque the shaft using the 5/16 inch hex drive socket to 300 inch pounds or 25 foot pounds. If the cotter pin hole slots do not align, increase the torque to a maximum of 450 inch pounds or 37.5 foot pounds for proper alignment. Under no circumstances should the nut be loosened to obtain proper alignment. If the cotter pin holes do not align after reaching 450 inch-pounds or 37.5 foot-pounds of torque, remove and install a new nut. Install and secure the new cotter pin, bending and cutting the tab in accordance with Continental Motors Maintenance Manual M-0, standard practice for spark-ignited engines, to ensure proper clearance with the engine face gear bolts when the alternator is installed. Refer to the aircraft manufacturer's maintenance manual for the proper post-installation alternator checks.